All right. It is Maria and Marc's vlog, episode 6, more of our adventures. The very beginning, you may have seen a castle on top of the hill. That is Castle Rock. It's a beautiful fairy tale kind of castle. It was built over 100 years ago. So, this vlog, we had quite a few day trips since we went to what I call the Zog Castle in the last vlog. It was really Knowwood Estate. We went to a few different places. We went to Ithaca. We went up the Hudson Valley. We went to Riverhead. We went to Upper Brookville to see I think I called it the Cutting Room Arboretum or something like that. I wanted to see waterfalls. So anyway, our first trip was actually not a day trip. It was like a weekend trip. And this is where we went. Our first day trip, which was truthfully a weekend trip, we drove from Lindenhurst over 200 miles up to Buttermilk Falls State Park in Ithaca. This clip is not mine, but this shows you what the waterfall looked like and what it should look like. It was falling. So we get there and the waterfall looks like this. It's dripping. I mean, it was a beautiful gorge. It was a nice day. It was great to see Tony and Sue, our cousins, but the falls was dripping. We saw some nice terrain, some nice brooks, and it was a nice weekend, but no waterfalls. The next weekend, we took a day trip. We decided to drive up the Hudson Valley, making a few stops along the way. The first place we went to was Hawthorne, New York, and we went to the Gate of Heaven Cemetery to see a very, very famous person.
Remember me to Herald Square. Tell all the gang at 42nd Street that I will soon be there.
The man, the myth, the legend, the man, James Cagney. Ah, what do you hear? What do you say? Ah, you dirty rat. It's Jimmy Cagney. James Francis Cagney. In fact, his wife's name was Frances. It was nice. And most people who know me know that I like cemeteries. Okay, the parking lot of the cemetery here, there's the Mount Pleasant train station. It's about 2 feet long. I've never seen a station so short and so little. We next drove from Hawthorne up to the Croton Dam and Reservoir. The waterfall at the Croton Dam is beautiful. It comes out of the spillway, and I'm not sure if it's a natural waterfall or a man-made waterfall, but it's beautiful. Here's a clip that I took quite a few years ago, and there's the waterfall doing what it's supposed to be doing. So what happens? We get to the waterfall, and guess what? It's dripping. Boy, oh boy. The biggest waterfall I think we saw of the two trips was this one. Well, we left the drippy Croton Dam Reservoir and we drove up to Garrison's Landing. Garrison's Landing is on the east side of the Hudson River, right across from West Point. Very, very nice. It's a very meditative type of area. It's just really nice to sit there. But what's interesting about Garrison's Landing is that way back in 1969, it substituted for the city of Yonkers
in the movie Hello Dolly with Barbara Streisand.
We are inside of this building or house, whatever you want to call it. We're going outside, okay? And in the distance over there is Garrison's Landing. And I'm on the balcony of this building, okay? But I want to show everyone where this is. I'm going down the steps. This building was Van de Gelder's storefront in the beginning of Hello Dolly.
And of course, Van de Gelder, Horace Van de Gelder, was Walter Matthau.
And if no one believes that it's not Van de Gelder's, well, there it is.
That fragile woman, that sweetheart, that mistress.
That window up there is where Barbara Streisand was going up a ladder, saying, I feel an updraft in my panties.
Mr. Kemper, do you mind if we climb in? I'm feeling an updraft in my underpants.
Oh, Mrs. Levi!
This is no way to elope.
If you follow my suggestions, not only will Horace Van de Gelder give you permission to get married, but he will also dance at your wedding.
Down this street is where they sang Put On Your Sunday Clothes.
Pitch your toe. Just like a dream, your spirit seemed to turn about. That Sunday shine is a certain sign that you feel as fine as you look. Beneath your parasol, the world is all a smile. That makes you feel brand new down to your toes. Get out your feathers, your patent leathers, your beads and buckles and bars. For there's no blue Monday in.
This was the old train station. It's not used anymore. It's like a theater. And the new train station is a little further down.
Put On Your Sunday Clothes was shot in front of this. They had a couple of more accoutrements on top of here. Right, sweetie? Sway, say accoutrements.
Accoutrements.
Ah.
Hi.
Accoutrements.
Accoutrements.
And in the film, this gate wasn't here.
This shot that I'm emulating was done in the film where the train comes out of the tunnel. And interestingly enough, heading south. Then drove from Garrison's Landing about 4 miles north to the town of Cold Spring, not to be confused with Cold Spring Harbor on Long Island. And George Washington slept there. He slept in a lot of places. Cold Spring is a very quaint little town and with a lot of stores and antique stores. The train depot there is a restaurant, and there's the story of the poor woman who was murdered by her husband at the depot in the late 1800s, and then supposedly her ghost haunts the place. A couple of weeks later, we took a trip up to the North Shore of Long Island, Upper Brookville, with our good friend Janice, and we went to the Cutting Field Arboretum and saw a lot of pretty flowers and posies and beautiful plants and trees.
Not a weeping willow, but we're like surrounded by tree with it's like a monkey tree. And there are the monkeys.
And it's nice, it's shady.
And a new member to our vlog, my good
old Janice.
Janice.
Yeah,
Janice, tell everybody like what you're doing here today.
Oh, I love being here. It's a beautiful day, great friends. Just need a bottle of vino and we'll be perfect.
Vino, ah, vino, yes, bella, 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 forte, forte for tuna. Tuna fish will be good too.
But what I was amazed is that it's right on the same grounds as the Coe Mansion. I've heard of the Coe Mansion, but I didn't realize it was there. It was a sprawling, dark, shadowish kind of mansion, a Gold Coast mansion. We didn't go inside, but very picturesque, and a pleasant time was had by all.
This has what Knollwood did not have. It wasn't torn down. Their backyard and gardens. Maria didn't like the greenhouse.
I liked it.
It was just too hot.
It's so freaking humid in there.
How hot was it?
It's
very hot.
Now we're underneath this little baby weeping willow. It's really
It's cute. Not a weeping willow. It's a pine.
It's like a
thingy.
Pine weeper. Maybe we could take this out and bring it home with us and put it where she took it.
It's like wisteria gone amok. It's beautiful. It's a bunch of them. Actually, there aren't a bunch of them. This one goes down and then they have other ones every
where
20 feet or so. Mr. Chipmunk. Hey, chippy fella.
And then a few weeks later, we took a drive out east on Long Island to Riverhead. And we went to the Long Island Aquarium. And I gotta tell you, the place is pretty fishy.
Yeah.
We saw all manner of fish. We saw sharks. We saw beautiful fish. We saw octopus. We saw gators. We saw ugly fish. This year we wanted to go to Paris, and of course that didn't happen because of this pestilence, but it will pass just as a lot of other things will pass. But the most important thing, and I know Maria would agree, is that we all have to be true to ourselves, and the most important thing is compassion and caring and love, and at the end of the day, unity. We have to be like this, not like that. We'll see you next time.
Well, what's it there?